Later this month, the business world will celebrate National Corporate Philanthropy Day. It's part of an effort to inspire companies to create more partnerships with charities. CBS2 charity contributor and philanthropic advisor Lisa Dietlin is here to explain how you can get your workplace involved. And many companies and corporations make charitable donations.
Yes, they
do. But you say they should do more.
I absolutely think they could do more. In 2006, the year for which we have the most recent numbers, $295 billion was given away, Kristen.
That's a lot of money.
That is. But only 4.4% came from corporations. Mm-hmm. That amounts to about $13 billion. 83% came from individuals. Wow. Another way to look at it is, against their profits, it was less than 1%.
Yeah. But when you think about that money figure, that's a lot. Why should charities do more?
Well, there's many reasons. The first of which I always say, it's good PR and marketing. If they're getting this much attention for 4.4%, what would they get if they did much better? We feel better when we go into a store and we know that a certain percentage of the dollars that we are purchasing a product goes to a charitable cause. I remember when I was looking for workout shoes, the Ryka brand donated a certain percentage of each sale of shoes to the Rose Foundation, which was Recover Our Self-Esteem. So there's that opportunity, good PR and marketing. The second is, it's good for company morale. Employees like to work in companies that give back to the community. They like to say, hey, I work for a company that really does good. It allows me to volunteer during the day. And guess what? It has a corporate matching gift program, meaning for every dollar I donate, there's a dollar that the corporation will get.
Which leads to the next question. You talk about corporations donating, and that might make the individual feel a little helpless in the whole endeavor. So how does the single employee make a difference?
Well, employees have been known to make differences throughout all of our history in the workforce.
Right.
The number one way is to take advantage of the volunteer program. If you have a volunteer program at your company where they allow you to go during the workday, do volunteer. Do go and volunteer with a group of your colleagues. Stock those food bank shelves. Clean up that riverfront. Build that playground. Whatever it is that moves your heart, go and do that. The second is to think about asking the corporation to get involved. If you don't ask for that contribution, that donation, who is going to speak up?
Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Ventured, nothing gained. Okay. And also remember that a lot of corporations give away donations in kind. They give away product and services. IBM, for instance, 68% of what they give away comes in product and services. So ask. When I served on the Cabrini-Green Legal Aid Clinic board, a legal firm, a law firm, donated their used computers, which for us was a huge step up, even though for them it was, they were improving their system. It was a win-win for both of us.
All right. Lisa, thanks for being here.
Glad to be here.
It. And for all of the advice, as usual. For Lisa's top five tips on corporate philanthropy, remember CBS2 is always on at cbs2chicago.com. Just click on Morning News.